Adventure bikes are some of the most sought-after motorcycles in India. With their squishy suspension and confidence-inspiring riding positions, they're one of the most apt motorcycles for our Indian roads. This is one of the latest entrants into the assortment of budget adventure bikes in India. And today, we're going to tell you why this Adventure 390 isn't a bike for noobs. This bike needs no introduction. This is the 2021 Adventure 390, and basically it's a Duke 390 on stilts. But it is so much more than that. And let me explain the differences between a Duke 390 and an Adventure 390. So both bikes are based on a steel trellis frame, but both of them have very fundamental changes in the chassis because they're tailored to different sorts of situations. The shock absorbers are the same, but again in different settings. WP43mm front shock absorbers, which are in a different setting compared to the Duke 390, and a WP Apex monoshock at the back, which is again in a different setting. What is the same though is the engine. The single cylinder 373cc motor is a beast, and well, it has loads of power and is very nice to ride around with. They also get the same gearbox and they get a lot of electronic rider aids. For example, you have cornering ABS, switchable ABS, traction control, and a few more bits and bobs here and there. So this bike is seeming to be a very familiar bike with loads and loads of electronic rider aids. So why am I saying that this is a bike not for noobs? Let me explain. For someone new to this segment or the concept of riding in general, this bike is a little bit too powerful for them. Throttle control is a very crucial thing while riding this thing off-road or on some loose sort of terrain. Because the thing is, this bike can easily spin up its rear wheels, which can make you high side or lose control of the bike very easily. KTM has apparently said that the engine has been tuned a little bit differently to have more low-end torque. Maybe in KTM land, the amount of torque this has at the low end is quite a lot, but compared to other adventure bikes like the GS310 or even the Himalayan, the low end torque on this is basically non-existent. That means you have to be high up in the revs to get some sort of grunt out of the engine, which means throttle control and throttle response is also a very, very crucial thing while riding this bike. And that sort of skill improves over time, over experiences, so that's why this isn't the best engine for newbies getting into off-roading or any sort of adventure touring. The non-adjustable suspension is very stiff, maybe even a little bit too stiff for someone new to the segment. If you don't know the proper tricks, techniques, and riding positions to do while going off-road, this might end up being an injury for your back. While on loose gravel-like situations where you have tiny rocks on the terrain, this thing will end up bouncing around here and there quite a lot, and that's where body control and throttle control is very important, and that is a skill that you acquire 2-3 years down in your riding experiences. The stock MRF tires that you get on the Adventure 390 do not give the necessary sort of feedback or even grip while going off-road.
A tire change is highly recommended on the 390 Adventure. India has banned the import of foreign-made tires because it is hampering the sales of Indian-made products. Therefore, all manufacturers have to give Indian-made tires from the factory on the stock bikes.
The quick shifter on this bike has apparently gotten a lot of slack for being of more of a on-road feature rather than an off-road feature. The tune-up on the quick shifter is a little bit too jerky, and in off-road situations that might be a little bit of a letdown because it might make you lose control of the bike if the shift is a little bit too jerky. So that thing needs a little bit of fixing. The handling of this bike needs a lot of respect. The thing is, it's still a Duke 390 underneath somewhere. So It's very snappy when you're going into corners, and you need to give it a lot of respect while doing that. Again, like I said, the suspension is very stiff. The tires aren't as good as they seem to be. So on off-road situations, this thing can oversteer, snap, and make you fall very, very easily. So you need to have a lot of experience while riding these. Pros on this bike are loving it, and they're extracting each and every ounce of performance from it. If you want to have the maximum amount of fun from this bike, learn riding properly and then get on to this. Even though this might not be a bike for beginners, this is a great value for money investment. You get a powerful motor down there, some great electronics, and in general, the bike is very capable. So if you're someone who knows how to ride, this is one of the best bikes you can buy out there in a budget. So if you're looking for a bike which is great off-road and you know how to ride, look no further than the 390 Adventure. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let us know if we've missed out some sort of point down there in the comments. And let us know what you think about the 390 Adventure. And I'll see you in the next one.